Some Republicans are now publicly creating some distance with President Trump over the constant cycle of crisis over the Russia investigation. Republicans' latest fears come as special counsel Robert Mueller, he begins his investigation into the Trump campaign and takes over the investigation. Take a listen here to Marco Rubio, Senator Marco Rubio, and how he put it on CNN's State of the Union.
If any president tries to impede an investigation, any president, no matter who it is, by interfering with the FBI, yes, that would be problematic. It would be not just problematic, it would be, you know, obviously a potential obstruction of justice.
And Rick Santorum here saying Republicans, he could see Republicans breaking from Trump.
Unlike Democrats, who will never break with a president, no matter what they do. I mean, I don't care. You could find them with a smoking gun in a picture. They wouldn't break with them. Republicans will. And so I would say this to President Trump. This can't continue for a whole lot longer.
With me now, panel today, Angela Rye is here. She's CNN political commentator, former executive director of the Congressional Black Caucus. David Drucker is here, CNN political analyst and senior congressional correspondent for the Washington Examiner. And Paris Denard, a CNN political commentator and former director of black outreach for the George W. Bush White House. David, you've been doing some reporting on this. How real is the fear, I don't know, trepidation or fear right now amongst congressional Republicans with what's going on with the president?
I think they're very concerned and I think they're frustrated. And I think the way to look at this is to understand that they've seen President Trump survive a lot of scandals or a lot of, let's just say, challenges that would have felled a more conventional politician. And so they've learned to roll with it and they've learned to expect that what would kill them won't kill him. But I think over the past couple of weeks, they've reached a point where they no longer have patience for his unusual way of conducting himself from time to time. And they think that this is the kind of behavior and the kind of problem when you wrap up Comey with the meeting with the Russians in the Oval Office and so on down the line, that could really cause him problems that he can't get out of and them problems that they can't get out of. They were initially pleased to see the Mueller thought, all right, people will stop asking us about this.
Right.
Mueller will take the investigation and we can move on. And now what they're worried about is you never know where a special counsel investigation goes. And this could land right in their lap right before the 2018 elections.
Be careful what you ask for. Paris, the Russian investigation, it so clearly is not going away. I mean, from your perspective, what do you think the president can do in the meantime as the investigation continues to unfold to try and reassure Republicans?
I think the president needs to do exactly what he's doing, and that is having a successful foreign trip. For all intents and purposes, the trip to Saudi Arabia was a success. Former Congresswoman Jane Harman said so, a Democrat, and many others have praised that trip. He's going over it right now, as we've seen the images coming across CNN in Israel. And these are tough things that he's doing. He could have just done the easy thing to do, Canada and Mexico, but he decides to go to the Middle East, Israel, as well as the Vatican, the three major religious centers in the world. And so he needs to focus on that, focus on trying to broker peace, trying to eliminate ISIS. And then when he comes back, focusing on the budget, focusing on the things that are positive that can be wins for him. The president is a winner and he wants to have wins. He needs to focus on his agenda, stay on message, and not be, you know, sidetracked by this Russia investigation, which a lot of it is just perpetuated by the media. The American people are looking for him to be a leader.
Come on.
And that's what he'll do.
Come on, Paris. I mean, perpetuated by the media? We just have news that Michael Flynn is now going to plead the fifth. That's not perpetuated by the media. That's called reporting the news.
I think there's, and we can also report on other things in the news, like the positive things that are going on in Saudi Arabia that the president has done.
So there's extensive coverage of this, Paris. I mean, let's not get into like editorial judgment on the rundown of my show at this very moment.
No. I'm not talking about editorial judgment. What I'm saying is the American people are looking for this president to stay on message and for us to highlight the things that are positive. That is how he can win over the confidence of the Republicans that are running for Congress in 2018, because they know that this negative media coverage, 24/7 news cycle, is not going to help them in the long run. So he has to stay on message and stay focused on the positive things, and hopefully those things will be reported.
Angela, what's your take on this?
So a couple of things. One is I don't think that the American people are looking for Donald Trump to stay on message. Paris, I think you corrected yourself later and said that is a hope of folks on the Republican side of the aisle who are running for congressional seats in 2018. But I think right now the American people are looking for an opportunity to get to the bottom of everything Russiagate. If you look at polling numbers, they indicate very clearly that most Americans do not approve of how Donald Trump is handling this scandal. If you look at the numbers of even white men who supported him in the election, they're actually very frustrated with how he's handling this overall and his job writ large. If we're talking about this latest trip and we're going to start calling this success, what I think in the back of my mind is something, Parrish, you know very well, which is that big mission accomplished sign behind George W. Bush when he was president. There's no mission and there's no accomplishment right now for Donald Trump.
There's somewhere in between. I think Donald Trump.
No, but what I'm saying is there's no mission
accomplished banner behind him so far.
No, what I'm saying is it is a figurative banner that Parrish just painted. I'm not saying that's a real thing. I'm actually saying it's a fake thing. So there's fake news coming from the mouth of my good friend Parrish. There's no fake news happening on this show, though. And my whole point is this. The only person who can steal Donald Trump's thunder on his Middle East trip is him. And he just did it in the presser with Netanyahu. He said, nobody said Israel. Nobody said that you did. So it's like that little kid argument where it's like, well, nobody said I said that. Well, nobody said that you said that you said that. It's like, it's crazy. He's doing that himself.
Okay, let's go to the news that I did bring up about Michael Flynn. Now, CNN's reporting that Michael Flynn is expected to invoke the Fifth Amendment, his Fifth Amendment rights, and not testify before the Senate Intelligence Committee regarding all the subpoena that they had issued to him. So the Fifth Amendment, this is something that we have heard before, not so long ago, with regard to the campaign trail, right? We have President Trump who said that absolutely Michael Flynn should ask for immunity. I do wonder what President Trump will say about Michael Flynn invoking the Fifth Amendment after he said this on the campaign trail.
Here's people taking the Fifth Amendment. Four people plus the guy who illegally did the server. You know, he put in the illegal server. So there are five people taking the Fifth Amendment, like you see on the mob, right? You see the mob takes the Fifth. If you're innocent, why are you taking the Fifth Amendment?
Added to the file if there's a tweet or a soundbite from the campaign trail
to
everything.
There's something for everybody. Don't forget when Lois Lerner, the IRS commissioner, took the Fifth Amendment in that IRS scandal during the Obama presidency, Republicans were very quick to point out, and probably correctly, well, there must be something there, or she'd talk more. Look, this is going to, you know, for the time being, perpetuate the news in that there appears to be something going on with the Russia investigation. And I wonder if it doesn't all get back to Michael Flynn as the cancer in the Trump administration that he was forced to fire and still seems to regret it. Because everything about Russia that we know of, at least, really gets back to Flynn and what he did and what he didn't disclose. There were some other things with Jeff Sessions and things like that, and he was forced to recuse himself from the investigation. But we now have Comey coming to testify.
Right.
In the next couple of weeks, we now have this Flynn matter, and so this is going to go on for a while. And Angela did make a very good point. Trump has always been his own worst enemy. Most of what we think we need to look into in regard to Russian meddling in the election has come from what Trump has said himself, or been reported to say over the past couple of weeks. And every time he has a good moment, he follows it up with some kind of tweet storm that messes them all up. Well, and so it's on him.
We have some very big moments that are going to be coming up. David, Parrish, Angela, thank you guys so much. We're waiting for President Trump and Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. We're keeping our eye on...